I would like to start with you. You mentioned the concept of return, not in a physical way, but like keeping in touch, being in touch and understanding the society still. And you also mentioned that many Iranians here, they are really following the news and also they keep in touch with their friends and family. What would you say? Because I could imagine in the mind of many of us is always a question of what could an individual do? So each of us, what could we do? So just you surely mentioned, but I would like to give you a bit more.
Okay. Of course, I think the main point for individual people is that they, if they can keep the root, what does it mean? I think the personality of human is like a solution or a liquid in a glass. When we are 15 years, we are already filled with something. And if we are not happy with the content, we cannot easily empty it and refill it. It is impossible to make empty personality of a human, because we'll be die or somehow we'll be crazy. It is impossible. The only way, I think, because I am a person from physical chemistry areas, somehow I'm trying to make what I want to say in this way. If you are not happy with the content of your personality or with other personality, just we can add new solutions or solvents that with the time just will be diluted, and after several years the personality can be changed. Therefore, I believe the people who leave country after certain age, let's say for example after 10 years or 7 years, that they have already a basic education, not only in the schools but also in the family and in the society. It is really difficult to somehow make empty this part of personality. And even if we want to be a good person, for example, for our new society like Germany or some other places, I believe we have to keep the root in efficient way. It is not easy, but I see that sometimes people who go abroad and they are not happy about the situation in the country, they try to criticize everything about their education in childhood, about their family, that they say, okay, poor people, not educated, not everything is right. But I think this is somehow dangerous, because I believe even if you are not happy with the small house that we have, with limited facilities, for example, even if we define like this, because in other references, the small house that we think can be a great house depends to the view that we have. But even if this, we should not destroy the old house. We can make the new houses and keep the previous house, and we can be somehow try to use the previous experiences. What I want to say, keeping the root and somehow trying to make a link from former personality in the former society to link in an efficient way to the new one, this is somehow necessary whether this person wants to live abroad or go back to the original country. I think this is the first step. When we are like this, we can easily discuss with whatever person around the world, with the German or whatever. Because I see this is generally a question. For example, for a person who is more than 20 years in Germany, living here, asking always, am I a German or Iranian? But this is really, it is not necessary to find one question. This is a kind of come by personality. We have to accept it, we have to respect it, and I think there are a lot of course, difficulties, but a lot of properties for combined personality. Not only we have to understand and accept it, we have to explain this to our co-workers, because I see sometimes there are, for example, German or European colleagues that somehow, some of those, they expect that the people that comes, for example, from Iran or abroad, they have to leave everything, because they don't know our country, that there are a lot of good things there. They're somehow they think we should be happy to leave everything and to be just a new person in your society, but somehow this is not efficient and somehow even a little bit dangerous. We can be belong to the new society, but with keeping in efficient way what we have from the past. This is, I think, what if we do this, then we can try that how we can help to the original country, how we can build the association. But first, we have to solve the problem ourselves. Okay.
You would like to answer the same question?
Yes, I wanted to, excuse me. Yes, I really wanted to react on this directly and address some thoughts and share some thoughts with you. It seems like we all of us give the task to you. You have to solve this problem and so on. It's not your task alone. And we have to think about that, what is possible for you to do. Somehow migrants are struggling. However, I see you're struggling very well. You're looking very well educated, and you're not looking somehow poor. But however, there is a huge load for migrants to get their life organized, to do their education successfully. There's always this double or triple load we have on our shoulders. Therefore, it's not us who can solve this problem of brain drain alone. I think I always want to focus on one major stakeholder in this play. It's the government. I mean, imagine if the Iranian government would launch a call to the diaspora, hey, we invite you to work and to develop programs to lower brain drain from Iran. Mm. I mean, if the government calls, it's the lion in the field who calls. And think about how could we establish a dialogue that the government feels attracted to reach out to you, because however it will take place more or less in Iran and less in the diaspora, less in the host countries. So we have somehow to start to establish dialogues with the country over there. And many countries showed how well it works. Mali, for instance, Mauritius, a small country which passed its development level, the development level of Germany even. It's, I think, fifth or sixth place in the rank of the development level. It's Mauritius, and they really used strategies of diaspora development nexus. For instance, circular migration. How could you be attracted to go back to Iran to work in an Iranian company or university, to share your skills you have with the Iranian civil society? I think it will depend very much from the Iranian government, because they have to establish a climate where this could work. So I would really emphasize on this. Start thinking how you could interact, develop programs, and organize yourself, because the Iranian government don't know who to talk to. How are you constituted? What are your goals? Who are you? And I really join our brother here. Cultural aspect is very, very much important. The culture changes in Iran, and we are not getting it. You may think that while we are here and going back, we will find the same situation as 20 years, 30 years, 40 years before. It's not the case. So try also to keep up your capability to go back and to interact with the living Iran. So, some food for thought for myself.
A little bit going deeper in that, you recommend us to be more organized and concentrate yourself. How was it? Because you were the one who wrote many different diaspora, like African diaspora organizations together. So you build up this network, first in Northern Westphalia, and then in Germany, not European wide. How was the challenge? How did you do that at the very beginning level? When you think back, when you see we are at the first like stages, we have few organizations already. So we have ISA, we have IRASA, and WeHub will join us in the afternoon. And a lot more, but they are very politically active. So we are at a like emerging level. What would you recommend us, or what would you, when you compare with the first phases of the African diaspora networking, what would you recommend?
Yes. Somehow, the most important point is to manage diversity. If I look around here, I see Iranians, but you are diverse. You're coming from different regions of Iran. You belong maybe to different communities. The reasons to be here are different. The reasons to stay are different. And maybe also your goals are different. So to manage diversity was one strategy of success for many, many organizations who are doing a good work for a sustainable way, in a sustainable way. So keep that in mind, because we are not all the same. Second, you have to identify the motors in your community. There are always those people who are staying longer, working longer, because somehow they have a vision and they work very strong for this. But they are always few. But those you have to identify, because they have to do the work. At the end of the day, it depends on how many time do you have per month or per year to come together. And this is always voluntary work first. So this is the biggest challenge. It's always a challenge if there is not regular income to come together, to network. It's private. It's your own will. So you have your private life, you have your jobs, you have your education, and then comes your initiative, your motivation to work for your country or to reduce brain drain. So you have to be very realistic on time. Because when I was active in North Rhine-Westphalia, I could see so many statues of organizations, and I can tell you, African organizations, they want to save the whole world. I mean, their statutes of organization, it was books. Like, some wants to reduce conflicts in the whole continent of Africa. I mean, sorry, you are a small group of highly motivated actors, but you cannot solve the whole problem of Iran. So you have to be focused. But this is a process. Focusing is maybe the second most important, I would say, strategy. Hammer out your common goals and don't assume them. Just make a research and I would say interact a lot, discuss a lot first. Maybe even struggle, or somehow it could be also through conflicts inside of an organization. It's good to find out what the people really think. What is your goal? What is your goal? Is it coming together? Are you standing in the same? Are you going in the same direction? This is very fundamental. And try to find out 2-3, not more, goals per a certain phase. Before, let's say, learn from the African organization. Don't try to save whole Iran. stay focused on some pertinent, important issues.